The views expressed on the following program do not necessarily reflect the views of Money Radio 1510, staff, management, or advertisers, and do not represent an offer to buy or sell any securities.
It's time for Health Futures with Cypress Home Care Solutions, Bob Roth. This is Arizona's only show dedicated to providing you with expert advice on how to live a longer, healthier, and happier life. To learn more, call 602-264-8009. That's 602-264-8009. Now, here's your host, Bob Roth.
Good afternoon. Welcome to Health Futures Taking Stock in You. This is Bob Roth, your host, and we are here with a special guest, Dr. David Bailie from the Orthopedic Clinic Associates, otherwise known as TOCA. In the healthcare profession, we use a lot of acronyms, and TOCA is what they're referred to as here. But I wanted to let the audience know this is a weekly show here that we host, talking about healthcare, medical issues, and challenges of aging, and how to live a healthier and better life. And orthopedics is something that is near and dear to people, especially as they age and deal with lots of challenges relative to the bones and joints. I want to introduce Dr. Bailie here, and I wanted him to go through a little bit about his background. Besides being a University of Michigan graduate, and he is
That's right.
He bleeds. It's a blue and gold.
It would be maize and blue.
Amazing blue.
Amazing maize and blue.
Yeah, there you go. And he also has a son at his alumni, so he's very proud of his alum. But he's a very accomplished and well educated doctor. And I wanted him to tell us a little bit about his background, and then we're going to jump into it and talk about some of the stuff that you're doing and how we can all here in the Phoenix metropolitan community and wherever else we're reaching out through the web, how we can live a healthier life and better quality life. So welcome, Dr. Bailie.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be here.
It's good to have you. We go back a long way.
A long way, yes.
You moved here to the Valley about, what, 18 years ago?
96.
96.
Yeah, met you shortly thereafter, I believe, sitting out on a patio eating dinner or something.
We were very impressed. Your son, Braden, was maybe two at the time, and my wife and I were very impressed with the fact that he could handle chopsticks and was eating sushi.
Yeah, there you go.
He was very advanced. There you go. So you've been here for nearly 18 years, and beside your thorough education, and I'll have you talk a little bit about that, you've got some great experience in sports medicine.
Correct.
Can you tell us a little bit about your background and your experience?
Well, I always wanted to be a sports doc since I was in high school. So that was kind of my mission. And when you're going into medicine, the earlier you kind of figure out what you want to do, the better, especially in orthopedics where it gets very competitive as you go up the food chain from going to med school to the residencies you do and the fellowship. So I did a fellowship in sports medicine in Houston at the Baylor Sports Medicine Institute. And I worked with all the teams there. That was the last year the Houston Oilers were there. So I worked with the Rockets, Astros, and the Oilers, and then a number of Division I schools, University of Houston and Rice and things. So that was pretty much a year of just intensive. It was pretty much sports every day. Mm-hmm. And I came out to Phoenix. I was on a road trip with the Houston Rockets and met the medical team that was taking care of the Suns at the time. And my specialty was mostly shoulders. I do shoulder and knee surgery. And so they offered me a position, and we wanted to come out to Arizona. First time I ever came out here, I was living in Chicago going to Northwestern and came out here. It was 70 below wind chill on Lakeshore Drive, and it's about 75 degrees here. We came out in January, and my wife turned to me and said, "This is where we got to be." So I was going to work at it. Quick Trip or whatever I had to do to work here. So it turned out that it worked out quite well. So that's how I got to Phoenix. And then I joined a group that and worked with the Suns my first two and a half years here. I was the co-team physician for the Suns, the Mercury and the Arizona Rattlers, as well as numerous high schools and some local Phoenix College and some stuff like that. And then that transitioned into switching to my current group and the Orthopedic Clinic, which, as you said, goes by TOCA. Most people know by TOCA.
Well, they got a well-established name, and you guys do a great job of branding. And when I talk to people about my own challenges health-wise, it's always good to know an orthopedic surgeon. And I got to know David, Dr. Bailie, 18 years ago. And every time I've had a challenge, whether it be a twisted ankle or a torn tricep tendon or torn tendons in my foot, TOCA is where I ended up. And you fortunately have put me back together. Thank you.
I'm glad it's still working.
It's still working.
The warranty's over, though.
The warranty's over. I still have a screw in my elbow that you told me about. I don't feel it, so I don't think need to exercise that warranty.
No, you don't. That's good.
But really, in talking about your specialty, and I talked to you about talked to our audience about my elbow, your real specialty is shoulder. And you've gotten some great recognition about shoulder work as well as knees. And I would think that especially our audience that is listening in with our aging population, I would think that that's probably the two areas that are challenges for older adults, or knees as well as shoulders.
Yeah, obviously that's very common. And usually after somebody's been in my office, they find out another 20 people that they know have had shoulder problems or knee problems. It seems like they come out of the woodwork afterwards. But knees are the most common thing. I do arthroscopic surgery on the knee. I don't do knee replacement, but I do sports knees. And then my practice has transitioned to be very heavily in shoulders, because when I came here, there weren't any physicians in town that really focused on the shoulder. And so I was doing a lot of that and worked with some companies in development. And that's where my national and international reputation kind of started to fall into place on the shoulder.
And on the shoulder versus the knee, you're doing shoulder replacement stuff, correct?
Correct. I do shoulder replacement.
Yeah, because I've actually had a chance to study up on your bio, and I got this dissertation here showing diagrams of these pieces of hardware that are screwed into the shoulder and really putting people back together again.
Yeah, it's shoulder replacement's kind of become a very near and dear to my heart. Just the technology has advanced quite a bit, so being involved with development and actually doing some really new stuff has been really exciting.
Well, that is exciting, and we're going to get ready to take a break, but I do want to pick up when we do take the break is really talk about it's not just the injury and not just having successful surgery, because I know this firsthand, it's completing the rehab.
Mm-hmm.
And
yes.
I got to tell you, the rehab is really hard stuff, and sometimes it's even more painful than the injury, correct?
Correct, no doubt about it. I always tell people surgery is the easy part.
Right, and rehab and icing and getting back to normal is obviously the part that everybody wants.
Yep, that's exactly right.
We have to take a break for our sponsors. This is Health Futures, taking stock in you, and this is Bob Roth, and I'm here with my guest here today, Dr. David Bailey from TOCA, the Orthopedic Clinic Associates. We will be right back.
PhilsGang.com, Phil Grandy is dedicated to making you a better-informed investor.
The Phil Grandy weekly and daily combination chart, using that system, really puts you in the perspective to understand the direction of your trade.
Following your system has been fantastic. I've been with you for about a month and a half now, and I'm already up 7%.
The system that you teach is top-notch. It really works.
You can copycat Phil's portfolio investments. Plus, PhilsGang.com offers an array of online investing tools to help you execute investments on your own terms.
I've been in the business for a long time, and you're really one of the best I've ever heard.
The PTE2 allows for us traders to have excellent confidence in our positions as we work our positions down through the support and resistance area.
Become a member for only $49.95 a month. Go to philsgang.com, philsgang.com, or call 877-600-GANG, 877-600-4264, 877-600-4264.
Pipeline Oil and Gas is an energy asset development company that focuses on helping investors benefit from the modern-day oil boom, giving investors access to an all-star team of proven industry experts. Brandon Cox, founder and CEO of Pipeline Oil and Gas, is very proud of the fact that he invests his own money into each project before any investor is introduced to any potential project. Brandon Cox is the first to invest in a project to prove to investors he has a vested interest in the project. Pipeline Oil and Gas focuses on the revitalization of existing oil wells that already produce oil, and when needed, drill new wells in order to maximize returns on a project. By following this superior formula for success, they have consistently delivered a stellar track record for their clients by also educating clients on how to put their self-directed retirement funds to work and also demonstrate how to access the superior tax advantages associated with investing in the modern-day oil boom. To find out more, contact Brandon Cox today, 602-620-8272. That's 602-620-8272, or visit PipelineOilAndGas.com.
Bosch is the quietest dishwasher brand in the U.S. and now features a third rack. See it at Best Buy today or visit BestBuy.com/Bosch.
Now back to Health Futures, taking stock in you. If you have questions about your own or your loved one's future health care, call 602-264-8009. Now, here's your host, Cypress Home Care Solutions, Bob Roth.
Welcome back. This is Bob Roth with Cypress Home Care Solutions, host of your show, Health Futures, Taking Stock in You. And for those that are just tuning in, we have a great guest today. We have Dr. David Bailie from the Orthopedic Clinic Associates, otherwise known as TOCA, right here in Phoenix. How many offices do you have here in Phoenix?
I think we have five now. Scottsdale, Phoenix, Arrowhead, Tempe, Mesa.
And if people wanted to get a hold of you at TOCA, I know the website address is TOCAMD, TOCAMD.com.
Correct.
And is there a main number that people go through? Or?
You can call 602-277-6211. That's our main line. And then follow the phone tree prompts to get where you need to go.
Perfect.
You can also book appointments online at the TOCAMD website, and then I can be reached personally through my website, which is there's links to me on the TOCAMD website as well, but my website is sportsmeddoc.com.
And that's easy to remember, sportsmeddoc.com.
Correct.
And the great thing about TOCA is how many orthopedic surgeons do you have as your part of your group?
Oh, boy, I think 20. We have some full-time and a couple part-time. But about 20-something right now.
So if you have a challenge that you're dealing with, whether it be your wrist, your neck, your back, your knee, your shoulder, your hip, your ankle, your partner, Dr. Steen Johnson, was the one that put my foot back together. And he did a marvelous job, had a great bedside manner. And I really like – and I'm advocating the TOCA group because they have specialists inside this orthopedic group. So you don't have – a generalist that is one of those jack of all trades, master of none. You have the masters in each of the specified fields, and I think that is truly a benefit to our community.
Yeah, I mean that's kind of our philosophy, and we have the super subspecialists, kind of my niche, and there are a few of us that are subspecialists of subspecialties, and then there are the specialists. We do have one generalist who's very good. John Zoltan has been around the valley for a long time. And the generalist is actually an important part of our practice. It's kind of gone away because most people who go into training now do fellowships and become specialists, yet they go out and practice, and many of them have to practice general orthopedics. John has always been a generalist and extremely talented in a lot of areas, but also knows when a specialist is required and has him at his, right there in the
right.
In the office. So it really is the best of both worlds because there's some of the stuff now that I forget as it – when I used to do general orthopedics in my training, you could handle everything. Now the general stuff, which is technically not as complicated, becomes complicated for me.
Right.
So it's nice to have a resource to send that stuff to, that I can send that to.
And the other thing that I marveled about, and we didn't even talk about even having this conversation, was the fact that I don't know if each of the surgeons has a physician assistant, but when I was going through it, you had an assistant that was right there beside me. He was the one that took all my medical information and got me a lot of the answers that I was looking for, because I knew you were a busy guy doing a lot of surgeries.
Yeah, some guys do. I currently don't have one, and I'm not going to actually have one.
Okay.
I kind of like to be my own hands-on. My patients have my personal email, so I like to just know everything that's going on and go direct to the source. So I've actually changed my philosophy a bit.
There you go.
And but most of the guys do use physician assistants. But if you see me, you're going to see me and only me every time. I do have an LPN and a medical assistant that handle calls and some of the logistical stuff. And obviously, we have a big support office staff. We have over 200 employees, and they handle a lot of stuff for us.
Well, that's nice to know, especially for patients that, you know, because of my friendship, I was always able to get to you. But people that do come to you will be able to get to you if they needed to get an answer for a question or
absolutely
need something.
Every one of my patients has my personal email, goes right to my phone, and 365 days a year I answer it, doesn't matter where I am.
I love it. We left off before we came back on. We talked about rehab and how important rehab is to really getting better. I mean, like you said, surgery is only part of it. How much would you say is dependent upon rehab and getting back to close to being 100%?
Well, a lot of it depends on what the injury is, and if the injury required surgery, what the surgery is. So the fact is that rehab is critical. Much of the rehab you can do on your own if you're active, used to exercising, and spend a little time understanding what's going on. You don't have to spend a lot of time and money going to a clinic. However, it is easier when you have somebody who's trained teaching you what to do and supervising you and working with you. For surgical stuff, it's important, especially in the shoulder, for range of motion, to have a hands-on therapist. It's very difficult to do the range of motion stuff on your own. When you get into the strengthening, if you're used to doing something, you can often handle the exercise program on your own with just periodic visits to a therapist to be instructed on the next level of training. If you're into competitive sports, it's a whole different deal. When you get into competitive sports, whether at any level, recreational on through the professional level, it becomes harder and harder to reach your endpoint. And so you immediately get better and you work your way up the ladder. It's kind of like the stock market taking off, but then it plateaus pretty fast. And those plateaus are where people tend to peter out and not do their exercises, and they get to 85%, 90% better, which for most people, that's fine. You don't have to be 100%. But if you want to be 100%, that last effort is hard. It's like running, doing the Ironman triathlon. You know, the beginnings for somebody who's even well-trained is pretty good, but it's that trying to get that last mile done
right
on the run that's the hardest of all. You may have been going for 9 hours, and everything boils down to that last mile, and that's what therapy is as well. That last mile is very difficult, so a lot of people stop at that before they hit there, and that's probably okay, but the more competitive you are, the more you want to do later on, the more the more important it is to continue to push through that and cross the finish line.
So important for our listeners to hear that. I mean, if you want to get back to where you were, you got to complete it. And interesting enough, and I know this having been through physical therapy, there's some things you can do, some things you can't. And one thing for sure you can't do to yourself is breaking up scar tissue. And I got to tell you, that
it's too
hurts.
Painful.
Oh, it hurts. But, yes. You know, for those
it's a good pain.
It is a good pain. And those that are listening in that have been through this understand that. But in order to recover, you got to break that scar tissue up, so you can get mobility and the things that you
absolutely
need.
Absolutely. And the relationship between the physician and the therapist is important. We have therapy in all of our offices. I use a lot of our own therapy. But I also use some guys outside of our group who I've worked with for years. And one in particular, Todd Ellenbecker, who's the medical director for the World Tennis, takes care of all the professional tennis players. And he and I do all my shoulder research is done with him. So we have a really good relationship. And we've published our therapy protocols in journals and textbooks. And every patient who goes to him always says it's a great experience, but it is the most painful thing they do. But they know it's a good pain, and they actually put up with it quite well. But it's all about the art of it. And so having a good therapist with a good relationship with people who actually have the hands to do whatever they do, and I'm not a therapist, so I can't get into the specifics of what they do. All I know is that when my patients see certain therapists, they do very well. And I think it's because of the revolving door of the relationship you develop. They know what I do. I know what they do. I just know it works. The recipe works. Don't mess with the recipe.
Exactly. And having been someone that has gone through the surgical process, therapy, like I said, is so important. And a lot of people sometimes don't really put that much time and effort into it.
Absolutely.
So I really appreciate you spending some time on that. I wanted also just to share with our audience, there was a news release that came out last month talking about a study that was being put on by Biomet Orthopedics. And I think this is really important for us to share with the audience because, you know, you have gotten some incredible recognition for your shoulder stuff that you do. Can you tell us a little bit about Biomet? Because I think you're one of like four docs worldwide that is doing this.
Well, this study, this is a Biomet asked me to be a part of a small group, four docs, myself included, to develop a new shoulder technology for replacing the shoulder. It's a stemless shoulder technology. Currently, the standard is to put a stem into the bone to hold a ball in place on a shoulder replacement. So this technology was acquired from Biomet France. Biomet's a worldwide company. It's based in Warsaw, Indiana. And they acquired this technology, but they weren't happy with the way the technology was currently designed. So they asked me, I got Dr. John Sperling, who is up in Mayo Clinic in Rochester, a guy from the East Coast in Baltimore, and a guy from University of Toronto to redesign this. So we spent years working on this and retooling this. And then to get it approved to be used in the U.S., you have to go through an FDA study, which is a multi-million dollar protocol. It's very difficult. And so it was the device was released in Europe last year. It's taken off. The Europeans love it. It's being used all over Europe. But in the U.S., we had to do a study. And that's there are 12 centers in the United States that are part of the study. I'm the only one west of Memphis, Tennessee, allowed to use this device for probably the next 5 to 7 years.
Wow.
And if you qualify for a shoulder replacement and qualify for this study, and you're in my office, you potentially would be offered this. It's a pretty fascinating device, and we're really excited about it. And so far, the Europeans have put several hundred in. They don't have to do a study, and so we have the luxury of seeing their results, which are actually tremendous.
You know, being someone that deals with the aging population, the challenges I often see with falls, and falls are stuff that, you know, are things that can happen to people. And when you and I were kids and we took a fall, we brushed off our knee or brushed off our elbow and just kept on playing. And let me tell you something, I took a fall recently in my garage and I went down like a sack of potatoes, and man, did that hurt. But just imagine someone that's aging in the 60s, 70s, 80s, or even 90s taking a fall. One of the things that, or a couple of things that happen, it's usually a knee, a hip, or a shoulder that you're dealing with. And, you know, the shoulder is something I see a lot of. So this type of research and this type of things that you're doing are extremely beneficial to our community. I'm going to have to take a break, Dr. Bailie. So we're going to come back. We're going to hear from our sponsors. This is Bob Roth, Health Futures, Taking Stock in You. And I'm here with Dr. David Bailie from the Orthopedic Clinic Associates, TOCA. And we'll be right back.
We pause for a look at the world's news. Then we're back with Money Talk. We're Money Radio 1510 and 99.3 FM.
NBC News Radio, I'm Ron Allen. As the tension continues between Russia and Ukraine in the Crimea region, NBC's Ian Williams sat down with Ukraine's interim president. He asked him what the country is looking for from the United States.
He said financial stability. Without that, then freedom and democracy would never be entrenched here. And he was immensely grateful for what he's heard this last couple of days from the U.S. and from Europe about financial aid.
Russia is slamming European Union sanctions, saying they will not remain unanswered. Here at home, a Florida mother who drove her minivan into the ocean in Daytona Beach with her three children inside has been charged with three counts of attempted first-degree murder and child abuse. Volusia County Sheriff Ben Johnson.
She tried to stop somebody from going into the vehicle. That's one of the reasons you have the premeditated attempted first-degree murder, is she definitely tried to kill her children from everything we have seen.
This is NBC News Radio.
If diabetes has you at the corner of a lot to figure out and a little help would be nice, you can count on Walgreens. With 24/7 expert pharmacy advice on medications and tracking your glucose, plus savings on prescriptions and supplies, we'll help you live well with diabetes. So talk to your Walgreens pharmacist today, because taking control of diabetes takes an extra hand. Walgreens, at the corner of happy and healthy.
Now here's something you don't hear on the radio every day. Someone who can't see. I am totally blind. So I go through periods when I'm unable to sleep at night. And I feel like I'm constantly running, but can never quite catch up. But this isn't a sleep problem. It's something called non-24-hour disorder. Learn more about non-24 by calling 855-856-2424 or visiting learnmorenon24.com.
Your Ford service technician checks a lot of things to keep your car healthy.
Synthetic blend oil change, check. Tires rotated, check. Brakes inspected, check.
They keep your vehicle on the road with a thorough inspection.
Steering and suspension, check. Battery tested, check.
That always includes expert service,
check.
On even the little things.
Belts and hoses, check. Fluids topped off, check. Wipers and lights, check. All done by an expert Ford service tech, check.
And you get a great deal,
check. Right now, get a complete vehicle checkup with the works, just $39.95 or less with a $10 mail-in rebate, making it just $29.95 or less. So check maintenance off your list at your Ford dealer. Up to 5 quarts oil. Taxes, diesel, and disposal fees extra. Rebate by prepaid debit card. See participating Ford dealer for exclusions and rebate details through 3/31/14.
It's great to learn a little something every day, especially when it concerns your financial security. School's in session at Money Radio 1510 and 99.3 FM.
Did you know the federal government is about to make getting a mortgage loan even more difficult than it is now? It's true. Joe Capitano here, Senior Vice President with Homeowners Financial Group. Now, shortly after the first of the year, regulations still being written will begin to impact anyone seeking any type of mortgage, whether a refinance or a purchase. You know, historically, the end of the year is a slower time for refis or purchases. But, you know, it just can't be this year. If you're thinking about buying or selling, or you got to call me. I have loan programs most lenders don't have. And I shop the rates. You know, never has been more critical to get sound professional advice. You know, affordability is one of the targets. You know, don't risk potentially higher rates or prices that could spoil your dream of home ownership. Call me this week or go to joeloans.com and I'll send you a comprehensive report on the value of your home for free. Call me, Joe Capitano, 480-305-8545, or just simply go to joeloans.com. Banker number 0906222 and NMLS number 98826, Equal Housing Lender. Joe Capitano, joeloans.com.
Are you tired of paying too much to watch your shows on TV? Hey, if you can't see the difference, why pay the difference? Switch to Dish, where promotional prices start at only $19.99 per month. Not only will you get the same channels you know and love for less, Dish will also sweeten the deal with free HD for life, premium movie channels, and Blockbuster at Home for 3 months for free. Did I mention that promotional prices start at only $19.99 per month? Dish is home to award-winning technology like Hopper and Dish Anywhere. Switch to Dish and see what real value is. Free HD for life, special discounts on premium channels, scores of movies with Blockbuster at Home, plus extra savings when you bundle with DishNet high-speed internet service. Get the same channels and pay less with Dish. Call your Dish authorized retailer at 800-863-5196 for details. That's 800-863-5196. Again, 800-863-5196.
Limited time offer. Separate 24-month agreements and cancellation fees apply. Restrictions include credit qualification and auto pay and paperless billing. Call for details.
Their name is Safe Auto for a reason. Safe because it's smart to have car insurance, and auto because that's all we do. The right car insurance for the right price. Right now. 1-800-SAFE-AUTO.
Who is leading the smartphone market? This is the Dow Jones Money Report. I'm Jen Ursulo. Apple continues to lead the smartphone market by market share in the U.S., followed by Samsung and LG Electronics. Google's Android remained the most used smartphone platform according to ComScore. In the last quarter, nearly 160 million people owned smartphones. That's a 7% increase from October. Stocks continue to drift lower as tensions build in Ukraine, where the region is deciding on whether to split away and become part of Russia. The Dow Jones Industrials were up only 4 points. points at 16,426. The Nasdaq down 23 points. The S&P 500 down 2. Skullcandy shares are surging 28%, hitting new year highs after the headphone maker's better-than-expected fourth-quarter results suggest a quicker turnaround than previously thought. So just how bad was the winter weather last month? According to newly released government data, it was so bad it kept 600,000 employees from making it to work. That's more than double the number from a year ago. Jen Ursulo, Dow Jones Money Report.
Your season for big savings is deer season. Choose 0% financing for 60 months or get big cash off select new John Deere tractors from our one family through our powerful 6M and 6R series. These offers won't last long, so hurry in today. Offer ends April 30, 2014, subject to approved credit on John Deere financial installment plans. Some restrictions apply. See dealer for details.
Visit one of Stoats Equipment's 20 locations for great deals on legendary John Deere equipment. Find the location nearest you at stoatsequipment.com and myjohndeeredealer.com.
Do you know what that sound is? That's your new digital marketing department. And that'll be your new web designer. And that's Haibu, where these experts are joined by many more, from web designers to search marketing specialists, who work hard to get your business noticed online and on mobile. Best of all, Haibu can do it all for you, or give you the tools to do it yourself. To find out more, go to Haibu.com. That's H-I-B-U.com. Or call 877-938-HIBU. Oh, that'll be your next new customer. Haibu, made for business.
Now back to Health Futures, taking stock in you. If you have questions about your own or your loved one's future health care, call 602-264-8009. Now, here's your host, Cypress Home Care Solutions, Bob Roth.
Welcome back. This is Bob Roth, your host of Health Futures, taking stock in you. And if you're just tuning in right now, we have Dr. David Bailie from the Orthopedic Clinic Associates, otherwise known as TOCA. And we were talking about the surgeries, we were talking about your specialty, we were talking about rehab. And you know, one of the things we talked about at the break, and I think it's really important for our listeners to hear this, is we were talking about deficits. And I know you were busting on me talking about my own deficits. And we will not share with the audience my own deficits. I know what they are, so thank you, doctor. But we were talking about
– or the national deficit. We're not going to talk about that.
Yeah, we're not going to talk about that here. We let the radio hosts that talk about financial news talk
Correct.
About that. But we're here to talk about health futures. And really, health futures is about taking care of yourself for the future. And we're going to get into this segment and our last segment about taking care of yourself and about men's health. But I want to really talk about, you know, all the specialties that you have and the Orthopedic Clinic Associates has with their orthopedic surgeons. Is a lot of our listeners have aches and pains and they put them off. And they think, oh, you know what, my elbow hurts a little bit. You know what, I'm just not going to play tennis anymore. That may be a really bad injury. So I want you to talk to our audience about what are some of those deficits that you're dealing with in terms of putting off that you really should be paying attention to. And I said this in our last episode that we did last week, is the body is an incredible machine, and it talks to you, and it tells you when things aren't working right. So please, Dr. Bailie, if you could talk to us a little bit about the dangers of putting things off.
Great question. And first, I'm a proponent that you will never fool Mother Nature. We are not even close to being smart enough to interpret things in our own way. So you have to listen to what your body says. And the thing about, I'm going to just talk about shoulders specifically since that's kind of my primary interest, and rotator cuffs, which everybody knows people now that have had rotator cuff tears. And the thing is, people often don't come in to see us until it really affects them. And your body signals may not mean that much to you. In certain people, they don't have a lot of pain. They could have a fairly significant tear and not have any pain for that matter. And I have patients every week who come in who have zero pain for years, and they have a massive chronic tear of the rotator cuff that is not fixable. So, but if you question them and probe them a little bit, they'll tell you, oh, yeah, my shoulder was achy, you know, 6-7 years ago, and I just put it off because I could still do everything I wanted to do. So the key thing is get information. You never have to act on information. A lot of people don't like going to the doctor, primary care, specialist, whatever, because they don't want to take a pill or they don't want to do surgery, they don't want to do anything. You're always can say no to everything. You can say no to cancer treatment. You can say no to everything. You are entitled to say no to every aspect of your health care, but you can't make a decision unless you have the information. So the key thing is to make sure you have the proper information. And I'm a little biased because I am a specialist, but really you need to see a specialist. I don't pretend to know heart disease, although I published a paper and presented it at the American College of Cardiology years ago, and it's turned out to be a major paper. But I couldn't tell you what a murmur is if it blew in my face. So the fact is that if you think you have a problem, it is always better to see a specialist, because if you don't have, you can't get the knowledge from somebody who doesn't have the knowledge themselves. And educate yourself. Do a little homework ahead of time, even if you don't know what it is. Maybe you think you know what it is. Do a little homework, because if you can come in to somebody's office with some educated questions, it always helps you understand. To come in blind makes it really hard for a physician to explain it to you, because it's like teaching you Chinese, and all you've ever done is eat at a Chinese restaurant. You're not going to be able to speak any of the language, and so you can't understand it. And so it's real important to get some basic knowledge of what you think the problem might be, even if it's very rudimentary, and come in with some good questions. But you're there to be educated. You're not there to get fixed. The fixing may come later, but you're there to be educated. So you can make a treatment decision for yourself in conjunction with your physician that will be right for you. And putting things off is the worst thing you could ever do. It never hurts to come in, have an appointment, and be told nothing's wrong, don't worry about it. It is just a little sore muscle because you played too much tennis. And that's really crucial.
You know, I know for me, and we, of course, we're talking about me and my sports injuries, and Dr. Bailey put me back together a couple times, but with my tricep tendon tear, you know, one of the things that you did tell me when we diagnosed it, and I say we, you diagnosed it, honestly, but when it was diagnosed and we weren't sure how complete the avulsion was, you said that we need to act pretty fast. This is something that we can't put off. And I think I remember being a little alarmed by the sense that I can't remember if it was 3 weeks or 3 months, but you said, if we don't do this, then we're not going to be able to fix it.
Well, the issue for in that example, you know, you don't have a crystal ball. So all I can do is educate you in that sense to say, okay, your triceps is tearing. It's hanging on by a thread. And if it snaps, now you have an urgent surgery. And now you have to make sure I'm available. You have to make sure you're available. You have to make sure your personal life is geared up so you can take time off, because now it's an urgent surgery, or you may not be able to fix it, or the complications go up. So whenever you see something that's pending, like in your case, it's the tricep starts to fray like a rope is fraying. If you know it's going to snap, if you know the fan belt on your car is fraying and it's going to snap, it's better to go in and get a new fan belt before you're on the side of the road in the middle of the desert with nobody to help you. So being proactive definitely helps. Sometimes surgery early is better. There are other times when surgery for those kind of things are it's better to wait till something happens, but at least you know what those are and what the right thing to do.
Oh, fantastic. And, you know, what's interesting is that men in general are probably not very good patients and not really good about going to the doctor and not really good about taking care of their own health. And I want to, you know, pick up when we come back, really talking about men's health and things that, you know through your own personal experience as well as professionally, that we need to do a better job of in terms of taking care of our own health. I really appreciate us talking about me and some of the challenges I had, and I have full range of motion.
It's not a HIPAA violation because you brought it up.
That's right. Well, listen, with that, Dr. Bailey, we're going to have to take another break. This is Bob Roth with Health Futures, taking stock in you. I've got Dr. Bailey as our guest today from the Orthopedic Clinic Associates. We'll be right back.
I'll never forget.
Never forget that moment.
As long as I live.
As long as I live.
My first call up ever as a member of the National Guard.
When we got to the armory, they briefed us on the wildfires. They were getting dangerously close to homes.
Helicopters were going out to drop water on the fires. Guys in the unit were preparing for firefighting with local fire crews. At that moment, I got my first taste of just how important the Guard is to my community.
See how the Guard can be an important part of your life at NationalGuard.com.
Sponsored by the Arizona National Guard. Aired by the Arizona Broadcasters Association and this station.
Dare to compare.
your high-risk, high-fee variable annuity to the concept of the principal-protected, low-cost, new generation annuity. Find out the real truth when they do the fee analysis, the income analysis, and risk analysis between the high-risk, high-fee variable annuity compared to the concept of the principal-protected, low-cost, new generation annuity. Call Anil Vazirani and Secured Financial Solutions at 800-957-5604, extension 200. Speak to Lee Marshall to set up a complimentary consultation to learn the facts that you may not be aware of in your high-risk, high-fee variable annuity. So please call Anil Vazirani and Secured Financial Solutions at 800-957-5604, extension 200. Learn more about fee, income, and risk analysis, complimentary, on the web at www.theripa.com. Guarantees based on the financial strength and claims paying ability of the insurer, not suitable for all investors. Investment advisory services offered through Brookstone Capital Management, an SEC registered investment advisor.
Don't you think it's time to map out your personal or business tax strategies? CPA and tax expert Ken Lindau will educate you on how to take advantage of some very valuable tax strategies using a truly self-directed IRA or solo 401k. Get the latest sound tax and financial planning with Ken Lindau every Monday at 4:23 on The Financial Review. And to learn more, contact CPA Ken Lindau at 480-940-8351 or lindaucpa.com.
SRP Business Solutions offers a variety of rebates for all kinds of energy-saving options, including refrigeration, window film, lighting, and cooling. Learn more and save with SRPBiz.com.
Now back to Health Futures, taking stock in you. If you have questions about your own or your loved one's future health care, call 602-264-8009. Now, here's your host, Cypress Home Care Solutions, Bob Roth.
Welcome back. This is Bob Roth with Health Futures, taking stock in you. And if you're just tuning in right now, we are a weekly show talking about health care and medical issues that are affecting our community and really talking about how we can live a healthier and better life. And right here with us today, we have our great guest, Dr. David Bailie from the Orthopedic Clinic Associates, otherwise known as TOCA. And we were talking about, in our last segment, we were talking about putting off surgery and some of the deficits that some of our people in our community are dealing with. And I want to get some opinions from you, Dr. Bailie, on some of the things we were talking at the break, and that was about some of the technologies that are out there. And one subject that comes up with anybody that is dealing with a bone or joint issue is, I often hear people talk about, and I've had them too, is cortisone. You know, how many cortisone shots can you get? Is cortisone good for you? Is it bad for you? I want you to talk about that and some of the other technologies and stuff that are out there.
Sure. Cortisone is very useful to us in orthopedics for certain conditions, particularly arthritic conditions. But in general, without belaboring the point, cortisone stops the healing process. That's what it's designed to do. It inhibits, shuts down all of your inflammatory process. To heal any injury, whether it's a sprained ankle or a fractured bone or anything, the process is started by an inflammatory process. So if you shut that down, you inhibit all the healing.
I think the word you use was, you turn off the fire alarm, right?
Yeah, you turn off the fire alarm and the fire is still burning, hotter than ever. So you disrupt the signals to your brain that tells you something's wrong. The pain comes from inflammation. And if you use cortisone, it does help. If you're in severe pain, you need something for relief, it's useful. But there's a cumulative effect of what it does to the tissues, and it deteriorates the tissues. It weakens tendons. If you inject around the tendons in the front of your knee, for instance, even one time, it leads to rupture. And there have been many publications showing that. There's actually not a single publication ever published that shows cortisone to be physiologically beneficial in any way. It just helps with your symptoms and in a detrimental way. So it's okay in certain circumstances. It's okay on a rare basis when you need it, but it's not okay if you keep doing it, even though it makes you feel better. And one caveat to that is, in joints that are already pretty arthritic and you're trying to put off a joint replacement of some sort, there's already enough damage. The occasional cortisone injection probably isn't going to make any difference, even if it does deteriorate the shoulder or knee, and it will potentially prolong the time that you need to consider surgery.
That's great, great information, Dr. Bailie, because I've had several cortisone shots, elbow, knee. You talk about knee, patella tendon. I had lots of issues when I was still playing lacrosse, and I was told I was only supposed to get so many shots because of the very fact that you talked about was tissue breakdown and stuff like that. So really, really important to know, and I love the metaphor about turning off the fire alarm and really stopping the healing process. So for those that are listening in the audience, I know that many people are thinking, just give me a cortisone shot and let me go. And yes, it takes off the pain, but it's not going to help you heal. And that's correct. Really, really a good point. In terms of technologies, we were talking at the break, and we hear all over the news about stem cells. And, you know, stem cells are the future, and I know there's a lot of stuff being done internationally with stem cells, and we have certain regulations here that the FDA's put us on. But I want you to talk a little bit about stem cells and your experience with stem cells, good and bad, if you could share that with our audience.
Sure. Stem cells are kind of a hot topic in orthopedics in particular. But stem cells are only FDA approved for certain cancers, basically. And that's it. And to do stem cells right, stem cells are basically cells in your body. They can be obtained from different sources that have not decided what they want to be when they grow up. And you can make them choose which cells they want to be. And that, there's a lot of advantages to that. If you can turn stem cells into an organ or a tissue of some sort by throwing some stuff at it, it will be very advantageous. If it's your own, it's even better. So there are ways to harvest your own cells. It's very cost prohibitive to do that and actually grow them and multiply them. You have to take the cells you harvest, which are just a few cells, and multiply them to hundreds of thousands, if not millions of cells. It's very expensive. So any stem cell treatments that are available that are being done now that don't go through that very costly process, they're not stem cells. There are other chemicals and factors in your blood that help stimulate things to grow. They're called growth factors, and there's a lot of them, and they do different things. And that you can take from somebody's blood and separate parts of it and do that in the office. We do that. It's called platelet-rich plasma. The studies are debatable whether they actually help in specific entities, but it is not felt to cause any harm. They do help healing in certain things, so we do use that. There is one company that does make what we call allograft stem cells, or stem cells from placenta tissue, and they have a way to preserve the cells. They're immunoprivileged, which means that you're not going to reject them because they come from a certain side of the placenta, and that's the only available stem cell available that's kind of off the shelf. You don't have to take your own stuff, and the studies are out there that it does some good, and a lot of NFL guys are using it, and a lot of professional athletes, but it's very expensive. But I have used that as well. It's not as cost prohibitive as doing your own.
You know, and one of the things you shared with us at the break is that, you know, as our audience listens to this, make sure you are working with a professional organization like the Orthopedic Clinic Associates, a professional like Dr. David Bailie, because, you know, we're hearing about stem cells, and we're seeing about any, you know, Tom, Dick, and Harry out there offering stem cell treatment, and we really need to be careful. Buyer beware.
Like I said before, do your homework. It takes you a little time. There's no urgent stem cell treatment unless you have cancer, and then it's approved for that. So the fact is, know what you're getting. Do your homework. If somebody tells you they can offer it to you, go do your homework. If it takes you a day or a week or a month to figure it out, do that first so that you really understand what you're getting and whether it's really what they say they're giving you.
We are, if you're just tuning in right now, we have Dr. David Bailie from the Orthopedic Clinic Associates. You can reach the Orthopedic Clinic Associates, TOCA, at 602-277-6211, or you can reach them at tocamd.com. And here we're wrapping up our final segment, and there's so much more I want to talk to you about, Dr. Bailie, and I just did not get to it. And I really, really feel bad, but I want to just want to thank you for being on the show, and I want to invite you back. And, you know, one of the things that we were going to talk about and we really didn't get a chance to talk about is men's health. And we are horrible patients, men are. And
well, I can jump in and say one thing that I think your listeners ought to know, because this has been a hot topic in the papers, but testosterone replacement therapy. And I don't do that. I'm an orthopedic surgeon. However, I have a lot of patients on it. Very controversial. Makes you feel great. And the fact of the matter is we don't know what it does to you over the long term, and there's a lot of suggestion it increases cancer rates, particularly prostate and some things like that. So as in anything in medicine, it's an evolving understanding, and like anything, you just need to educate yourself. Sometimes the answer from a physician is, I don't know, and that may be okay. You know, we're only limited by what we know at this time, and things change. So you just have to be educated, make your own decisions, but always make sure that you don't just do something or use something just because a physician says it's okay. I don't think that's a safe thing to do.
Well, you know, you talked about at the beginning of our episode here today, our show, you talked about fooling Mother Nature. And you really can't fool Mother Nature. And we all are looking for the fountain of youth. We want to be able to keep our youth. And, you know, Dr. Bailie, you've been able to keep your youth, but you got a little snow up on the top. You're catching up with me.
And I have a kid in college.
There you go. And you have a daughter, and I have three. That's
one
why
freshman in high school. Yeah, that's probably gives me more.
I'm sure. But, you know, there is no quick fix. We don't know those long-term effects. And, you know, one of the things that we do know is that if you are aging and – many of our audience is either aging or they have a loved one that is aging. If you don't have somebody at home to support you, you need somebody. You need an advocate. You need somebody looking after you because, you know, aging in place successfully is what we all want to do, but not everybody can do that.
Totally agree. And one thing, the older population tends to trust physicians more because back in the day, that was just what you did. I will tell you that it's always good if you're elderly and you're going to see a physician of any kind, you take a family member or a friend who can ask questions on your behalf to make sure you're educated. Some of these concierge primary physicians are great because they actually show up at the physician's office with patients, and I have a few that refer to me, and they're there so they can explain it to them later, and it just makes it better for everybody. It's all about information.
Right.
Ultimately, you make your own decisions. You have to have information to make a decision, whether it's your finances or your health.
And that's a great point. And the last point I want to leave for our audience, you have to take control of your own health care. You can't leave it up to somebody else. Take control of your health care. There's a lot of information. There's a lot of misinformation out there, too. So do your homework. My dad has a concierge doc and does exactly what you're talking about and really reaps the rewards for that. Well, listen, I have to wrap up the show, Dr. Bailie. I hate to do it, but I want to have you back.
I'll be happy to be back.
This is Bob Roth with Cypress HomeCare Solutions, your host to Health Futures, Taking Stock in You. I'm here with Dr. David Bailie with the TOCA Group, the Orthopedic Clinic Associates. If you need to reach him, 602-277-6211. Go make it a great day. We will see you later.
No place like home. You've been listening to Bob Roth's Health Futures. If you have questions about your own or your loved one's future health care, call Cypress Home Care Solutions at 602-264-8009. That's 602-264-8009. Or visit cypresshomecare.com. Be sure to join Health Futures with Bob Roth every Friday at noon, right here on Money Radio 1510 and 99.3 FM.
Certified income specialist Steve Jurich has helped many Money Radio listeners with IRA, 401k, and 403b rollovers. Here's why. Steve uses a combination of investments and carefully selected annuities that many advisors are not even aware of. Hear Steve and Sinclair Noe talk about your successful retirement Mondays at 4:35.